Welcome back. I guess it's a part three, right, for the David, my friend, and we did already a little bit on his front, on his arms, shoulders, chest, quads. Now it's time to work David back. All right, guys and girls, everyone has a lot of tension and soreness and pain in their back. General zones where people hold the tension, it's obviously upper back right here. Everyone who hold their phones, drive, sit by the computers for hours, you guys have tension right here on your rhomboids, okay? So this, yep, right here. That's a number one. Number two, it's your QLs. Quadratum lumborum, right here. It's a lower back. Lower back, a bit tricky because it doesn't act alone a lot of time. What involve, it's your piriformis, right here, from a lot of sitting, right? The back erectors, the erector spinae, right here. It could be involved, depend on your body structure, how tall, how wide, how, you know, how active your life or not active, how much you sit, stand, right? Depend how strong is your core. A lot of time when I work with my folks and I say, hey, you know, core, work your core and it will eliminate your lower back tension. People not really understand, but the reality, if people have a really strong core, planks, crunches, hip flexors, it eliminate probably 80% chance for you to ever have any lower back issues. So that would be number two. And number three, by like my personal feelings, what people complain would be trapezius, right here. These bad boys. By the way, those who are not aware, trapezius are gigantic muscles. They start from here, they go all the way up like this, they go up to here, and then a straight line. So it's like a huge triangle. It's a huge muscles. And when you sit at home, you're lifting your shoulders up, it's your traps. So my friend David said that he feel some kind of numbness in his fingers on the left hand. Left, right? Left. Okay, so sometime when he sits, sometime when he stand, even when he lay, he feels some kind of, you know, numbness on his three fingers. Let's say we exclude in some really bad diagnosis. In 99.5% chances cases, it's nerve pinching or pressure on the nerve, which comes from the cervical area, from your neck. Most of my athletes who give me those symptoms, it's muscular compression on a nerve. Where exactly? Sometime it's a problematic to find where the point where the actual compression happened. The practice shows helps to work the entire pathway of the nerve to the end. It could be all the way down, but that's a smaller chance. It could be a little bit on a on your triceps, which slightly higher chance. Shoulder zone, a high chance. Trapezius, probably number two. And number one, where I would begin our massage and loosen up muscles and back to, you know, unleashing all the tension, it would be neck. So, because that's where would be the easiest to compress the nerve, would be a neck. Because It's right here, the nerve came out from the spinal cord. If you can take just, you see, soft like a butter, boom, 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 see? If muscle does this, meaning muscle right now on stage of recovery, healing, it's soft, it's warm, it has a full range of motion, and whatever the structure muscle cross, it's not pinching, it's not contracting, muscle relax. Okay, check it out with the rhomboids. Technically speaking, I know maybe it's not work for absolutely everyone. We have different structure and body type, but if I can take two of my big thumbs, right, go a little bit under the scapula and create a little bit of the retraction, just yep. Create this type of motion. I can stretch his subscapula, right? This muscle which glued the scapula to the trunk. It's already saying me that his rhomboids not in a bad condition. Like, at least we loosen up them that it's enough, you know? In the beginning, when I was a young, fresh, you know, massage therapist, I was trying to fix everything at the same time and make sure I perform the best. The practice shows that it's a lot. That real good massage, it's a lot impact. It almost counts as an intense workout, and nerve system can handle only some amount of time under this kind of pressure, because even the person laying, the impact on nerve system are huge. Again, different type of massage, right? People can sleep during massage, then we can go for hours. But in reality, if you're an athlete or you're a person who has a lot of tension, a lot of soreness, I would not recommend exceeding more than 2 hours, right? Keep in mind, drinking a lot of fluids during massage, post-massage time, electrolytes, coconut water, have nice protein meal, and a lot of sleep. Like, come over here, check it out. Like, right now, you see the right side rhomboids right here, fighting a little bit. So here, you see, it's just soft. Here, you can feel the tension. So David is a left-handed person, and it's interesting dynamic that the side which is not dominant, so in his case, it's a right side. We usually use our non-dominant side as a support. And you know what that means? That if I do something with my right, I will lay on my left and move something with my right. And the non-dominant side usually have more stiffness in from the static tension. Like, good. Symptom, I need to go under the scapula. Yet, right here. Rhomboid major, right here. Oop. Boy, this guy is massive. 220, 6 days workout. Many, many years of experience, so. And I have to tell you, it's really not bad. Perfect. In an ideal world, we would be symmetrical, but we are not. And usually left and right side, we can feel the difference. Hey, do not eat my cream. So what are we dealing right now? Hamstring. Calves, hamstring, a little bit of the feet. We just finished David back and shoulders and neck. And now the last but not the least part of the anyone athlete body, hamstrings. You know how many people I ask if they stretch? Guess how many give me a positive answer? Almost nobody. So, I do understand. It's lack of time, no energy, you drain, you're tired, and most of the time, it's not a fun experience. So, stretching, same like a massage on these body parts, it's a process which takes a few minutes. Gentle warm-up. Let me take a little bit of oil, actually. Gentle warm-up. Especially if you have a lot of hair, like David, right? You can dig it in. You know, technically speaking, I use often even my entire body weight on someone hamstring like his. Just go like this, slide. You know. Yep. Right here. And just like a roller coaster, up and down. I mean, this man is 220 pounds of solid muscles, and you can imagine. Just his hamstring alone could take an hour. If those muscles haven't been deeply warm up before, it may take forever. So what I'm doing, I'm using body weight with my knees. So I guess it's like technique from the Thai massage.
I use a lot of cream, a lot of oil, so I will not pull his hair.
I guess you're feeling right.
External part of your thighs. Good. On his calves. Good. So the calves right now, as you can see, look, I can squeeze softer, you see? They're definitely not fighting. He's in a really good, like, relaxed state, like, you know, mental statement. His body not fighting. I'm dealing with a pure muscle tension, which, you know, result of intense lifestyle and really heavy workouts. A lot of time with people who not often or not familiar with massages, half of the effort goes towards make people feel comfortable with you, you know, with your touch, with the things that you work on top of the body. And, you know, the power differentiation, you're on top of the people, not even like physically, but, you know, you touch them and people have to let it go. They have to give you permission to take care of them, right? Which is not easy, especially if you work with this person only first or second time. Okay, you see the difference? Look, it's only a few minutes, but look. I can squeeze his belly, and the muscle kind of allowed me to do that, you see? It's no flexion. I can play. Good. All right, Fox. I don't know if you were able to see it, but for example, like how easy the right hamstring get squeezed, and for example the left one, you see it's still with a touch, it's hold the shape and tension. You see, like, it still required me way more effort to squeeze compared to the right one. You see, this get much softer. So now for the left one, I come back here to the calf. I do some lymph drainage techniques, right? So by standing with my knees on his hamstring and calves, I squeeze the muscles really hard. Now I'm pumping all the lymph back to the bloodstream. Don't forget about the lymph nodes right here behind the knee. Just a little pumped pressure. Once you start feeling like calf deflate a bit, feels softer, fight less, you know, you achieve. Sometimes it takes a while, maybe a couple of minutes. Sometimes it takes like 30 seconds. It don't surprise, it could be, each leg could be different. You know, people primarily drive with the right leg, right? So if you drive a lot like me, my right leg, my right calf may give up like twice longer compared to my left one. You can use pressure from both sides. And again, pay attention to the hair. You don't want to pull the hair. Again, muscle will recover and heal and grow and become stronger only once it shifted to the recovery mode, okay? So if the muscle remain on a fight and flight mode, you have really bad recovery. You have a really slow recovery. Muscle function on extreme, you know, circumductions. Once you shift your muscle to healing, it became soft, relaxed. And you can achieve this not just by only massage, but, you know, stretching, heat. Forgive me to repeat it again, but hot bath with Epsom salts, sauna, steam room, alternate heat and cold. You know, like you can sit in a hot bath and then jump under the cold shower for 30 seconds and do that alternation, which you would feel an amazing effect. With all that, I would suggest you always spend a few minutes on the feet. Same as your palms, feet, reflexology, it's amazing. Besides all the scientific and health effect, it just feels amazing, you know? Over 16 years of my practice, I met only maybe, I don't know, 5-6 person who said, please not, you know, don't touch my feet because hypersensitive, and they was just laughing and it was ultra ticklish. Everyone else, they love the reflexology and the good foot massage.
Hey, folks, check it out. You see, it moves much easier. So we definitely loosen up the chest, and David has right now way better range of motion. Check it out, his trapezius. His traps, much softer. So hopefully the pinch on a nerve somewhere in the path of the neck and shoulder will loosen up a bit, so he would have a little bit less, you know, numbness and tingling in his fingers. So it's a small improvement with every massage, with every physical therapy, with every recovery workout, with every stretching, which I'm wishing all of you would treat yourself once a week, once in a couple of weeks. And I don't know if it's possible to fix it in one shot, but you definitely can improve your health 5% at a time, and over a time you would feel better. I'm wishing all of you strong health. Please take care of yourself, and it's a journey. Little by little, it's a process. Thank you so much, and take care of yourself.